it's Larry here of Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show number 626. It's September. Jeff and I are back in the studio.
Are we still doing this thing?
We're still doing this thing. There's been a lot of people requesting that we do a podcast, and well, we do what the people say.
We live to serve. It is literally what we do.
And we're here, and we're back in the studio. We're having a, wow, what, it's September already. It feels like the last time we were here was July.
A lot of time has gone by. We've done a couple of Inside Xboxes.
And a lot of Twoxes.
Yes. And,
this week on Xbox.
For those not in the know.
Right.
And a couple of live podcasts, which were fun to do.
Right, on Mixer. We're working on scheduling another video podcast, which I love doing those.
They're pretty popular.
I mean, it's great coming in the studio and sitting in here and nothing but our bathrobes, but it's still fun. This is still fun nonetheless.
We could do a video podcast in our bathrobe and challenge accepted.
Yes, exactly. So anyway, welcome to the show. We were just talking. In fact, I was just coming into the studio and I was texting Laura, our good friend Laura, who used to be on the show.
Ran into her randomly at the airport.
You did?
Yeah, like maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago. I was going down. We've been, you might have seen some Forza Horizon 4 coverage come out this week. And so we were going around the country showing the game off.
And you ran into her.
And I was going down to San Francisco.
There she was.
And I was like, I recognize that jacket. And then we ended up talking for a good 20 minutes. It was great to see her.
Yeah, she just texted me. She works at Apple now, of course.
Yeah.
And she was saying how she got a hand on the new phones before they were released. So she was just telling me about them. So there you go.
Well,
after they were announced, she was telling me about.
Yeah,
that.
Well, you know, it'd be nice if she like let us in a little earlier.
Nah.
Maybe get us a, you know,
I don't know,
a prototype.
Yeah, I don't know about
that.
I
just want a new phone there.
Anyway, let's get back to games.
We've been playing a lot of games.
We have been playing. Well, we've been playing Strange Brigade, which we're going to talk about that. Yeah. We've been playing Tomb Raider. We've been playing PUBG. We've been playing Fortnite. We've been playing Destiny 2. You have, right?
Yes.
Goes on and on. It is, you know, up here in the Northern Hemisphere, it's the fall. Southern, it is spring. So it's the time when all the games come out as we get ready for the holiday.
And man, are they coming out faster than we can play them.
They sure are. It's
we're in the middle of it.
By the way.
Yeah.
And we're like a month and a half away from Red Dead.
Oh, my God.
Red Dead 2, Call of Duty, that Blackout beta looks amazing.
Oh my God, yes, yes. We're in the thrust of that right now,
right.
Actually, on Xbox One.
We got Forza Horizon 2. Forza Horizon 4. You talked about that coming out in just about 2 weeks.
And the one I know you're all waiting for.
Yes.
Actually, I'm like being a little facetious, except I can't wait for it, is Valkyria Chronicles 4 getting phenomenal reviews.
Is it?
Yeah, they were so confident, they actually put the reviews up about 2 weeks before launch. Comes out, I want to say September 27th, and
wow.
I'm trying to clear the decks for that one.
Why don't we go, do you want to talk about what we're playing now or going to the news? I mean, we kind of did. I mean, we have stories
to
write.
Let's dive into it. People want to know what you're doing, Larry.
Well, do they really?
I think they might.
Well, I'm doing Tomb Raider. I just got back from L.A. I was down in Tomb Raider. I saw Camilla Luddington, who was an Earl who does the
she's
voice
Lara.
Of Joe. She is Lara.
She's also a star on Grey's Anatomy.
7 years she's been doing that.
Literally the only thing my wife and I have in common is the fact that we have a Camilla Luddington connection.
Really?
In that I play Tomb Raider and she watches Grey's Anatomy. The rest of it, we live in the same house.
So great. Well, and then the common denominator is Grey's Anatomy is set in Seattle.
In Seattle.
Right.
That all,
now,
wow.
Funny story is I was talking with Camilla because I've known her for a long time.
Yeah.
And she and I were chatting. She's only been to Seattle once, even though the show takes place in Seattle because that's Hollywood.
It's not a documentary?
It's no,
I've
I'm just
thought
saying
it was filmed in
they
Seattle. I sprained my ankle and
really?
I tried to find Seattle Grey's.
Nope.
That's probably honestly not the hospital you want to go to.
Yeah.
Because then you got to worry, is this doctor distracted because of some love interest down in, you know, the OR or something like that?
These are the real things we talk about on the show.
These are the things I wonder.
Was down there in LA talking to Camilla. She was lovely.
She's so nice.
Well, she is.
Yeah, I met her during the Rise of the Tomb Raider.
Do you want to hear a story?
Of course.
Now, did you watch the stream?
I did watch the stream.
So if you watch the stream, go back and go to mixer.com/Xbox, watch the session. And so we're getting ready. We're about 15 minutes before we're going live. And there was a lot. There were just this hubbub of people. And I'm kind of looking at my notes and, you know, getting ready to play the game. And she's sitting two people to my right. And she's sitting on this chair looking lovely as always. They were, if you go look at, there's a live session, Xbox Live session sign that's sitting on the table.
Yeah.
Well, we had to place it very strategically in front of her skirt because the way the camera angle was.
This is going to get edited out, Larry.
No, I'm just merely telling you, there was a lot of care and thought put into camera angles because this is
blocking,
what you have to think.
They call it blocking.
Well, we do call it blocking. So, but it was just so funny. But she was great. Jonah, the Earl who plays Jonah was great.
So we're playing this game. Jonah quietly becoming like the tour de force. I'm like Team Jonah now.
Right. You are. I will let Earl know. By the way, he plays Overwatch. A lot of Overwatch.
Oh, bless him. Yeah, he mentioned it a few times.
Yes, yeah.
And you were trying to keep him on
target. He's Reinhardt. I said he doesn't.
He looks like a Reinhardt.
Exactly.
It's like the perfect. It's like anthro. Whatever. There's a word for it. Yeah, he's become who he is.
It was great. So, but it was a great stream, and it was a lot of fun. Thank you for tuning in.
I'm going to link into that. But and that was an interesting stream. It was good. I always love seeing those when you get to host with celebrities. They put you in there. But what I really liked is what you did afterwards.
Oh, could we talk about that?
It's your show. We can.
So yeah, it is. It's our show, Jeff. It's a community show.
Bless you.
So afterwards we wrapped up. I'm down in LA and I'm talking to some of the events guys and girls, and they're like, hey, we're doing this Forza Horizon weather simulator. I'm like, what? They're like, do you want to go check it out? I'm like, yeah, let's go. So we drive over to another studio. We're down in LA in Hollywood. We go to another studio and I walk into the soundstage, and sure enough, there is this box that's probably about 10 feet by 10 feet by 10 feet, maybe even a little bit larger. And in the middle of it is a sled, and that's what we call the racing rigs that you sit down and you have the pedals.
With the steering wheel.
With the steering
pedals,
wheel.
Yeah,
all that stuff. So there's a sled, and what they're doing is they are, it's an interactive simulator where you play Forza Horizon 4, and part of the Forza Horizon 4 value proposition, as we say, is the seasons, right?
Yeah, seasons change, and you get to
change.
That's a great song by Future Islands. Is that what you're referencing? It might be an older one, but previously, you know, we had weather changing, and
sure,
that was cool and innovative, yep, and it still is. It's still in the game, but then it was always the same time of year. And then if you recall in Forza Horizon 3, there was a great add-on pack called Blizzard Mountain.
Right,
that
was
fun.
And
it was all snowy. Well, now you get all the seasons in one package, and they're
right,
going to, after you sort of play through the game,
right,
and you get to sort of like have a tour of the seasons, then everyone's going to be on the same season together, and it really changes the way the game feels.
Right.
And that's like such a key part of a racing game is feel.
Right.
Plus it looks cool.
Right. So anyway, so the team set up this weather simulator where you sit in the middle, as you're driving the game and streaming this on Mixer. There's Mixer, because Mixer is all about interactivity and low latency. The viewers can impact what, as I'm driving, I can experience. So is it going to rain? Is it going to snow? Am I going to get mud in my face? Am I going to get wind? Am I going to
all of the above?
All of the above, none of the above. And sure enough, so I show up and they're like, well, we haven't tested it yet. I said, well, let's do it. So I stream it. It was completely just like, let's do it. So we streamed it on Mixer.
I'm linking to this right now.
And it was bananas. I watched it live.
Well,
you didn't even know I was going
to
do this.
No, you tweeted it, and I just happened to be, it was like 6 p.m. Pacific,
right,
and
right,
I just happened to be looking at my phone. I was like, you know what? We all need to watch this.
Right. Yes. And did I do okay?
Oh, you did great.
Okay.
It was clear. The thing I think is funny, if you watch this, is you're sort of goading them on. You're like, there. It's snowy in the game. Where's the snow?
Where's my snow?
And then you got what you asked for, and then some. And then I think they sprayed with mud.
Mud.
And was the mud chocolate?
I think it was chocolate because it had this weird milk chocolatey, cheap, like Easter Bunny chocolate melted smell to it.
Someone had like a tomahawk chipper shredder and was throwing Hershey Kisses into
it. It was weird. Yeah. So, but it was a lot of fun. And the funny, so we do the whole thing. And if you watch the stream, what you'll notice, Jeff, is that I'm driving, which is essentially the demo that's available now, by the way.
Yes.
Forza Horizon demo is available now.
Yeah, exactly. You should download that.
I'm driving and they didn't put any assists on. And that game is hard alone.
Yeah, but especially that particular sequence.
In a sled on the snow, it's really hard. Mm-hmm. So I came out of it, I'm like, guys, you got to turn some of those assists on. Because, I mean, having stuff thrown in your face and dropped on your head and splattered in your mouth while you're driving is all but impossible.
Yeah, but here's the thing. It was funny, and that's why you did it.
Was it?
Oh, I enjoyed watching that. So. And then at the end, it was clear that mud was dripping all over the place, and you couldn't wait to jump into a hot
tub. And let's be clear, I had really not prepared for that. So I had stripped down to essentially my underwear and my t-shirt inside that jumpsuit because I had the clothes that I had streaming. Meanwhile, an hour before, I'm sitting with Camilla Luddington, a Hollywood star.
I was imagining that she was sitting right off screen just watching you.
She went home.
No.
She's like, I'm out.
I'm
so, because it was completely separate.
She did
anyway,
what she needed.
So, Forza Horizon 4, as I said earlier, the demo is available now. Go
I'm
download.
Linking to a link. And don't forget, Xbox Play Anywhere, so Xbox One and Windows 10. Looks phenomenal on the Xbox One S, their X rather. It is a, I mean, it looks great on the S, but on the X, there's a performance mode.
Yes, there
that
is.
You can, so if you, so let's say you want to optimize frame rate over resolution,
yep,
where you can run it at a lock 60,
yep,
and it is butter. And if you're running on a 1080, personally, I prefer to run on 4K when you can, because especially the environments in the cars are so detailed. But if you're running, let's say, a 1080 TV and you have, yeah, an Xbox One X, running this on 60, oh my God, it is so smooth. It's beautiful. And if you have a Windows 10 PC, as I know we both do, actually, yeah, I've been playing on my Surface Book too.
Yes.
It's, you get the best of both worlds.
Yeah. Assuming you have graphics.
If you've got, yeah, if you're running, you know, a 1080 or I don't know what you have to run, the minimum specs, but it looks great. It looks great.
Now, it's interesting you talked about those two modes, because Tomb Raider, we talked about that during,
yeah,
the stream,
another one,
has similar situation where you can go with their performance or you can go with visuals. So one of the tips that Rich Briggs from the team gave us was, hey, run with the visuals. Then when you get into combat, you can just go switch it. And you don't have to reboot the game. It's on the fly.
That's really cool.
Yeah, Tomb Raider did a great job with that.
Yeah, I've from the very first moment they announced Shadow of the Tomb Raider, I've only ever seen it on Xbox One X, and it's something.
Really?
That's a, yeah. They had a couple of events back in May, maybe? I can't,
right,
remember.
Right.
And they showed it off and on the X, and it's just, it's nice working with a partner who can really, you know, push the hardware,
right,
nice and hard.
So Tomb Raider, that's, yeah, coming out in a couple of weeks. Actually, it's out,
oh,
now.
It's out now.
It's out now. I've,
if
totally
you're hearing,
forgot,
us, you're, yes, playing it. What do you think of it so far?
Oh, I'm having a great time. I mean, it's Tomb Raider's beautiful. I just, as I said during the stream, and again, you can go watch the stream, is it's just disturbing. In fact, I think I've got one. I'm going to pull it up right now. The I should tweet this out. The
photo mode?
Well, photo mode. Let's talk about photo mode first.
Yeah, so they added a full-on photo mode into Shadow of the Tomb Raider. And the way that differs from just taking a screenshot is it pauses the action, but then you can move the camera around and you can mess with things like the bokeh. Is that how you say it? The,
yes,
depth of field. You can change, you can put filters on it, frames on it. You can
bokeh,
have the title on it.
Bokeh. I think it's bokeh.
Bokeh?
I don't, we're not,
I don't,
I'm
not
we're
a good photographer.
Guys. Yeah,
anyway,
photo guys.
B-O-K-E-H. It's depth of field. Anyway, but the thing that people are having the most fun with is you can change her expression.
Yeah.
Now, while you're normally playing the game, there's a lot of like horrifying moments and the face that, I wanted to say Camilla, that Lara has, it matches, you know, the intensity of whatever she's doing. As she's,
right,
like swinging over a bottomless chasm or fighting a mystical jaguar, you know, her face is going to match that. But when you go into photo mode,
right,
you can change her face to make it
happy.
Inappropriately happy.
Right.
And that's the funny thing. So,
awkward.
So PC Gamer ran a series of screenshots where Lara's in like harrowing situations, but puts it in the photo mode and makes her smile. And it looks like the most messed up, like Instagram, you know, that you've ever seen, where she's posing in front of skulls or in,
right,
front of like someone who's, you know, coming after her or whatever. And why don't I link to that? Because I got a lot of good laughs on that.
It reminds me of when Grand Theft Auto came out on PC. I went around, remember, I don't even remember this. I went around and I did nothing but basically jump in the back of people's houses and took pictures of the pools. I don't know why, because I'm fascinated by pools. I love pools.
You know, when you fly into LA, it's amazing how many people do have a pool.
By the way, this is, I took this screenshot yesterday with none. That's, I see that a lot.
Just death?
it's just a black screen with, yeah, death.
You do die a lot more in this game.
And it's disturbing. We talked about the show.
You know, so these three games, the,
yeah,
Tomb Raider reboot from 2013, Rise of the Tomb Raider and Shadow of the Tomb Raider are like a three-game arc that sort of take the story of Lara from being just out of college, essentially, and recently orphaned, I believe.
Did you like this photo,
like,
by the way?
So I did the same photo. Did you see my
yes,
tweet? Like literally the exact same photo from another angle. I didn't post it because I was trying to find just the right... just the right caption. But yeah, it was funny that we both used the photo on the exact same
place. Exact same place on the,
yeah,
game where she's action shot.
Yeah. So, and I would say the first two games weren't necessarily hard. They were fun. They were phenomenal games. But there was very few points where I was like truly challenged, at least in terms of like figuring out what to do next. The gunplay could be challenging, especially later in the game. And I mean, that's great. But in Shadow of the Tomb Raider, the game does not hold your hand. There's a lot less of making it super obvious, like, oh, this is a climbable
area. It can, and Rich during the stream, he talked about that. There's three elements
exactly
that you can change the difficulty, you can slide them around. So it's really innovative that I've seen this.
Yeah, so you can independently alter the difficulty of exploration and like seeing things in the environment, of puzzles and of battle. So let's say you're someone who is you love the gunplay, but you really don't want to spend a lot of time trying to figure stuff out. You can put that part down to obvious. You click the right stick, which is the explorer or the raider, Tomb Raider's instinct. And she'll just literally tell you, oh, I should do this. And then you just do it.
But she'll also give you more verbal cues.
Yeah, exactly. But if you love the puzzles and you don't like you don't really care for gunplay, you can make the gunplay easier and less of an issue, and there'll be ammo everywhere, but you can make the puzzles real brain teasers. And like something that happened to me last night, I'm gonna play for an hour and I'm gonna stick on to the main line because there's a lot of games to play. There's so many side missions and so much to explore and do. And I was like, let me just like make a beeline for the end of the game.
Sure.
But then I found a challenge tomb and I was like, well, I'm gonna, you know what? It's optional, but I'm gonna go ahead and do this. I spent like an hour doing that, and I'd never, and like I had to puzzle over this particular sequence like for about 45 minutes to figure out how to get in there because it didn't hold my hand, and I loved it. And when I was done, there was that sense of accomplishment of solving puzzles that honestly I hadn't had since like the older Tomb Raiders back in the day that really didn't hold your hand.
Right.
And so if you like that challenge, that sort of mental challenge as opposed to the get good reflex challenge, you know, you can set it independently that way. And I love it. And there's just a lot more to do in this game.
Yeah.
Huge
check it out.
Areas the whole
looks
time.
Great, plays great, it's fun.
And I'm linking out to that the headline was turn a grim nightmare into an awkward vacation with Shadow of the Tomb Raider's photo mode. I think we're gonna see some
Shadow of the
stuff
Tomb Raider. Check it out now.
Yes.
What else? What we should talk about is, we talked a little bit about the Forza Horizon demo that's coming out in a couple of weeks. We have a show, the next episode of Inside Xbox. We're breaking up. You are going to a different continent to support it.
Are we talking about that yet?
Well, no.
No.
We just tease a little bit.
All right. Well,
so we'll have more details on that probably next week.
Yeah. Oh,
or maybe the week after.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, whatever.
But we play... Tally-ho, Jeffrey.
Oh, dear. The Strange Brigade.
We're playing the Strange Brigade, and it is just delightful.
So, very good. I'm sure the complaint line is lighting up from the direction of the UK. Strange Brigade. This is from the team that made Rebellion, who made the Sniper Elite games, or at least the most recent ones. And it's a...
Nothing like those.
No. A four-player...
Because you and I did some of those co-op.
We did.
Yeah.
A four-player co-op... sort of, actually, it's kind of very
puzzly
tomb raiding, but it takes place in has like a very like 1930s-esque like
Raiders of the Lost Ark kind of thing.
But the narrator is what makes
the voice of God.
Who is
this guy?
Yeah, well, actually, you don't want to know who he is because I looked it up. His name is Glenn MacCready.
Uh huh.
And he's got quite a
Is he theatrical?
No, that's what I expected. He's does tons of voiceover stuff. He's been mostly in smaller games. He was in The Pillars of the Earth. He was prior Philip. I did play that. Shadow Tactics, Blades of the Shogun. That's all. Yep. Tropico 5. Yep. I'm just naming some of the games he was on Xbox. Risen 2. He was in Wallace and Gromit, but he has like
stop the kid. I love that. I love Wallace.
But
and
he
Gromit.
Has a really sort of wide ranging resume. He did start off in TV, but he's just such
this may be some of his finest work.
This is great stuff. Like if you liked, what's his name? Sir Hammerlock.
Yes.
From
Borderlands.
Borderlands 2.
Yeah.
Just that over the top sort of like Teddy Roosevelt-esque, adventurer.
Yeah.
But he says a lot of funny stuff.
Yeah, like Jeff and I were playing it, and we had somebody join us just randomly.
Yeah, and what?
And he was good.
He pulled his weight.
Or she was good.
Yeah.
But yeah, we played it, and just the voiceover is just hysterical. The puzzles are fun, and it feels... And I'll just give you guys a tip. If you download the game if you can, buy the game, play it with your friends. And Jeff and I sometimes, because we're busy, we can probably play like an hour and a half. It's like each level is about an hour, and we just have fun.
Yeah. I've had a ton of fun with this one. So Strange Brigade, definitely worth giving a shot. Watch some streams, whatever you want to do.
Yeah.
But the narrator just like constantly, like you're stopping
Jeffrey.
For a second. Yeah, yeah. It's so ridiculous that it's great.
By the teeth of the queen, what have you done?
It's a real Donnybrook. Oh, Queensberry rules, eh? I don't even know what half the stuff is, but I think it's hilarious.
Strange Brigade. It's not what I thought what it was.
No, and I'm glad we spent some time with it. Hopefully we'll get some more. We got to set aside a little
bit
more.
What other news do we have?
We're going into news?
Well, actually we do have a little bit of news. Something we've talked about it on Twalks. We talked about, PUBG went version 1.0.
Yeah, sure did.
So congratulations.
So achievements are there.
Chivos are there.
And some of them will...
Retroactive.
Sort of, yeah, so if you've been playing throughout the Xbox game preview era,
yeah,
and you upgrade to 1.0 and you launch the game, you may find some achievements just... It could rain on you like a slot machine of achievements.
What you had that happen to you recently with something?
Actually,
Strange Brigade was giving them up pretty easy.
There was a point where we did pretty well there. I think also, my favorite one was the original Destiny.
Right.
I played a ton on Xbox One, and then it was essentially the same game on Xbox 360.
Right.
And I had borrowed someone's disc, and I popped it in, I signed in, and it gave me all those achievements again. I feel like a real Ray Cox, a real Stallion 83.
Oh, good old Ray.
Yeah, good old Ray. Close to 2 million gamer scores.
He's still cooking.
Yeah.
Good for him. All right, let's get to those headlines. Over to the news desk. We'll get to the weather later with the hurricane, but right now Jeff's going to give us the headlines.
Oh my God, we'll have to talk about that. But yes, Forza Horizon 4 has gone gold.
Hooray.
What does that mean?
Well, that means, Jeffrey, that the code is ready to be printed on discs and distributed, or in this case, printed on discs and also getting ready for digital distribution.
So it means the game is just about done.
Well, the game is done. There'll probably be a day one patch.
Well, I mean, yeah, and they'll continue to support it and change, and the seasons will change every week. But effectively, it should be just an exciting marker that, hey, Forza Horizon 4 is almost here.
Yep.
As you know, it's October 2nd, and you get it a few days early if you have the Ultimate Edition.
Yep.
A couple other things noted is that just yesterday, the Turn 10 team announced the Best of Bond car pack.
I can't do it anymore. Yeah. I've had them on the show, so they are friends of the show.
Really? My day.
Really? Yeah, I had his daughter on and his her brother on.
Oh, the broccoli folks.
Yeah. So they were delightful.
What a name.
Right.
It's a wonderful name.
Anyway.
I'm going by Jeff Cauliflower moving forward. So it just makes sense that in a racing game that takes place in good old Blighty, that you would have the Bond car pack, especially since, you're driving all kinds of
even those
cars,
weird time in
Aston Martins.
Even those weird time in the, like, I think it was the late 90s when they did a deal with Ford.
Did they have a deal with Ford? I remember they had a deal with BMW. Well,
I remember they had a deal where they had to drive the Mustang, and he drove it like when they were in like Cuba or some, maybe it was some South American, it was somewhere below the equator or above the, I don't remember, some tropical.
Was this
country.
Like a GoldenEye era?
Yeah, exactly. It was a Pierce Brosnan era.
Yeah. I don't know if those were my favorite. Great video game.
Well, this will be for another discussion for our movie podcast.
Well, we all know like the Aston Martin DB5 is sort of like that classic Sean Connery car. It was using Goldfinger, Thunderball, Golden. And I at one point Skyfall, which was a phenomenal movie.
Well, yeah, they had Inspector. It as a nod to the end.
Yeah, but a number of other cars throughout the year. Do you remember from For Your Eyes Only, the Citroen 2C V6?
Yep, that's the one with the door that opens front.
Well, I guess you do remember. Yeah. I'm like, who was in that? Timothy Dalton?
Was
that a Roger Moore?
That was a Roger Moore.
Okay, middle era.
Spy Who Loved Me.
No,
Moonraker. What did you say?
For Your Eyes Only.
And who did the, I don't remember. Oh, Sheena Easton. She did the...
Good Lord, the recall. The recall on this gentleman. Stratospheric. There's a Jaguar. There was that BMW.
Or as they say in Europe, I think it's Jaguar.
Jaguar. Yeah. Blake Bortles probably says Jaguar.
Jaguar. Yeah, that's it. Because I think even in, I don't know if this is a spoiler, but in Tomb Raider... She gets attacked by a jaguar, and I think Camilla says it that way. Jaguar. Yeah.
Jaguar. Yeah. Okay. Well, I'll have to go play through that sequence.
But this
actually,
is a vehicle.
That was a frightening sequence.
Yep.
But yeah, you know what? It is kind of almost like a horror game.
Yeah.
In many ways. I love the new Shadow of the Tomb Raider. Anyway, so Best of Bond car pack, and of course that demo. That demo gives you a really meaty slice of what the game is. So I highly recommend you. You take some time off why not? And go ahead and just
what are,
get a
so
feel
I'm
for
sorry.
The game.
Could you? What are the cars in there again?
So there was the Aston Martin DB5. There was the Aston Martin DBS.
Right.
AMC Hornet X hatchback. The Lotus Esprit S1 for The Spy Who Loved Me.
That's the one that goes underwater.
Okay,
that is the white one.
I remember that.
That is the white one that, that was the white one that goes underwater, turns into a submarine, called Wet Nelly.
A couple of other Aston Martins, the Jaguar.
Is the Hornet in it from The Man with the Golden Gun?
The AMC Hornet X hatchback from The Man with the Golden Gun, 1974.
That's a funny one.
This is...
There are actually a lot of AMCs in there. There's a whole bunch of AMCs, if I remember correctly.
I couldn't identify
that car.
The
Matador, the Concorde, a Jeep Wagoneer. The list goes on and on.
Apparently. Okay. AMC, does that stand for American Movie Classics still?
No, it doesn't.
No? Okay.
Go ahead.
Anyway, so that's it for Forza. But anyway, the game's phenomenal. We're seeing some streams that are coming up from the demo. There was a lot of footage, like a lot of the big racing YouTubers, like your AR12 Gaming and your TC9700 and Jack Ultramotive were putting out their videos. And so it's good to hear from, I can sit here and say the game is good all day. You're not going to believe me, or maybe you will. I actually love the Forza Horizon series, but hear it from other folks and sort of get excited. Oh, and another element, by the way, if you are going to play via Xbox Game Pass on October 2nd, you can get ready now. So you can buy a year of Xbox Game Pass for $99. That's like, what, $8 a month?
Yeah.
And you will get to get Forza Horizon, Forza Motorsport 7 and Forza Horizon 3 now.
Right.
You can play those games now, and then you have until, I think, September 30th. So that'll get you ready for Forza Horizon 4, which, of course, is included as part of Xbox Game Pass.
Hooray!
It's the deal that, the gift that just keeps on giving.
Every month, Jeffrey. Every single month.
It's funny, it's like, every time a new game comes out, and you probably get this too, like some of your friends or your family are like, oh, hey, can I get that? And it's just like, here's Game Pass. You're done.
Yeah,
you got it all.
Game Pass.
You got it all. You're done.
That's the answer.
That's it.
You want more games? Want more games than you could ever play in a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month, 2 months, 5 months? Game Pass.
I want to thank the Game Pass team for making my conversations with my family as short as possible. It's just Game Pass. Go. Bye. Bye. We're done.
Grandma's asking you for games?
She's down. She's retired. What else is she going to do?
That's a good point.
Sit there and watch the lizards crawl the trees?
So that's only...
They're pretty big. They're pretty big down there, Larry.
There's only so much canasta you can play.
She's gotten really into bingo. She's weaponized bingo. She's running like 5 cards at once.
Okay.
Here's another game that is something I got to play at Gamescom. State of Decay 2 Daybreak Pack.
That
came out this week. This is a siege, zombie siege experience is the term they're using. So basically you and up to 3 teammates, and if it's just you or you and a friend, then an NPC or two will come in there and help you out. You're basically holding down a fort, a base that can be destroyed from an ever strengthening and ever more growing numerous squad of zombies, including the new Blood Plague Juggernaut, which you don't want to mess with.
Right.
The longer you make it into this, you don't have to worry. This isn't your regular character who can die. This is sort of like a free reroll that you get. So you don't have to worry about losing somebody from your main game. And you can play through kind of like risk-free. And the further you get into it, and the more, the better you perform, you end up unlocking weapons, not just for this mode, but that will go back into your community in the base game of State of Decay 2. So let's say you've hit a wall, you're kind of low on supplies, whatever, you can play this mode and it may help you sort of like break through there. You might get some explosives.
Were you playing with us when I got my guy ripped apart?
I sure was.
You, me, and Graham.
I remember.
And
we all, what happened is that the Juggernaut came in and we all ran.
Right.
And you didn't. You stood your ground and you paid with your life.
I did.
That's kind of how it goes. You need better friends.
Yeah.
Because we're not.
Yeah, you guys
did not have your back.
I turned around. You guys were gone.
No, that was, gone. That was bad news. But you know what? It made for good footage. And that's, you took him up for the team. And it was on, you were like, oh yeah, that's my permanent character.
Not anymore.
Anyway, so it's something you can play over and over again, and it's only $9.99. There's some new achievements, some new gamer score, and definitely worth checking out. People had a lot of fun with this during Gamescom.
If you want to check, if you want to see what's going on, just head over to my blog, majornelson.com, now going on its 14th year.
You should put like a... sort of like when you look at your profile on Xbox.
Right.
You can see how long you've been on Xbox Live. You should put that on the top.
So anyway, check over all the details, the sales and everything we mentioned is over there.
Here's something else going on this weekend.
Yes.
What are you doing this weekend?
I think we're going to play the Blackout beta.
The answer was, I don't know.
I don't know.
We're doing a bit here, Larry.
Oh, I don't know.
How much money do you have in your pocket?
I don't know.
How much money?
Zero.
Zero. Oh, well, that's great. I got just the game for you.
Okay.
The Division, Xbox One.
Can we do that again?
Free weekend.
Can we start over?
We can.
Yeah, go ahead. Start.
Hey, Larry. Yes. What you doing this weekend?
Gee, I don't know, Jeff. I don't know.
But do you have any money?
Yeah, no, I have no money. No, I don't know money what to do.
Well, you know what?
What am I going to do?
You're in luck.
What?
I really hope we don't edit this properly. The Division, Xbox One, free weekend begins. Well, it's actually going on probably at the time you hear this for Xbox Live Gold members. So, we've talked about this before, jumped back into the Division when they announced since E3, when they announced sort of these medallions or these the commendations that they put into the game, shields that will sort of go over into the Division 2. And so, and I'd realized that I hadn't played in a little while.
That's true.
And there's a lot of stuff waiting for me.
You have
some exotic weapons.
What have you been doing?
God only knows. I'm experiencing missing time, so maybe alien abduction.
That would explain a lot.
Yeah, more than you know. But yeah, so if you haven't played before, this is the perfect time to just jump in there, literally no cost. Or if you haven't played in a while, you might want to see what's waiting for you, because they've added a lot of different new modes, a lot of new missions. There's a lot of new spaces, like in the back of your base, you can run down the stairs, and there's a whole other underground warren with some pretty difficult stuff and a lot of cool weaponry. So anyway, that's happening until September 16th.
All right.
Something else a friend of mine has been working on.
Is there more?
Well, I mean,
there's always more. Yes, Larry. Tis the season.
Minecraft. We love Minecraft.
We do.
Cool merch showing up at Target. So I think Minecraft has been really good at coming up with like cool things outside of Minecraft you want. We've all seen like the creeper hoodie. We've all seen like the diamond pickaxe that sort of turns into a sword. I have that at least. And there's also like a torch that you can use as like an actual like lamp, and you can hang it on your wall. Anyway, very clever. Anyway,
I have three of those in my home office.
Well, do you have them
the
like
ones
all
with the rotate, the bottoms rotate?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I didn't know we had those around the office. I'll have to pick one.
I don't know where I got them.
Anyway, so we've teamed up with Target, and there is now going to be in the US, and there's going to be 80 only at Target Minecon Earth merchandise.
Pieces. 80 what?
80 different things.
Okay. So it's not like 80 pieces.
No. But there's even like some cool stuff happening as part of Minecon Earth. There's going to be an in-store event on September 22nd. God, it's Minecon already.
Minecon.
There's going to be like mobs in the store. There's like a Minecraft scavenger hunt. There's going to be, you have early access to a Minecraft
like
mini game.
You like Target.
The Target, we call it.
Yes.
It's has a French, getting a lot of support for Target here in the studio.
Yeah.
They're building one in my neighborhood.
Are they?
Not far from it. Yeah.
The gentrification of your neighborhood continues.
Yeah. I don't know where everyone's going to park, because parking is sort of optional in Seattle. But anyway, and the first 200 guests to select stores will get to meet certain folks. So there'll be like content creators.
Where do I learn about this? There's too much information. You know,
it's minecraft.net. I'll link to it.
Yeah, let's put a link to it.
But there's some cool stuff.
Show notes.
Some of Jerome ASF, Shovel, a few other folks that like famous YouTubers are going to be at certain Target stores around the
US. Am I going to be at one? I'm not a famous YouTuber.
You're not a famous YouTuber.
No, I don't have time for that.
I mean, don't you though?
People get enough of me every week with This Week on Xbox.
I'm not debating that.
Every month is Inside Xbox. I got the podcast. I'm available.
You can't
everywhere.
Turn on the Xbox without your face just smiling.
And I'm sorry for that.
Well,
millions and millions of people. Okay.
Yeah.
PewDiePie who?
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 What? Okay. This thing just... So earlier today. The mail person came through. FedEx or whomever.
Oh, here at the office.
Here at the office.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah,
I know where you're going with this.
And you're like Jeffrey.
Yes,
you call me Jeffrey. You
That's
and my
right.
mom
yes.
only
Jeffrey because you don't sit next to me. You're a few desks away.
I'm like a full 10 feet away, which necessitates
Jeffrey.
Yeah, that happens several times per day. And you were just like, come over here. What is this?
Right.
And there was an Xbox One X.
We knew what it
box.
Was, but I was like, why?
Right,
am
well,
I
you knew that.
Why
you
am were, I getting an Xbox?
Yeah.
One
why
X?
Would someone? You probably had three in your home. But not like this. So we're celebrating the release of Solo,
yes.
A Star Wars story.
Yes.
Which is coming, of course, in 4K Ultra HD. You
4K
can view it.
On it's Xbox beautiful. One S or
so
X.
So many pixels, over 4,000 of them.
Right.
Just in the horizontal axis. A special Solo Star Wars Xbox One X.
Sitting at
made.
My desk right now.
It's at your desk right now, and it's something. that you can win.
Yeah.
Of course, it comes with Solo: A Star Wars Story on 4K Ultra HD Blu-ray.
Yeah.
And you can enter at soloxboxsweeps.com. I'll just link to
it. I'm going to give one away too. I haven't decided yet.
So we're going to be doing this at the end of September.
Mm-hmm.
This is a beautiful, beautiful console. The controller looks great.
Kind.
It's got the Millennium Falcon on
one
it.
One of a kind.
It's got like a cool matte finish. Like, obviously, winning one of these would be great, but they don't all look like this. This one's really good. This right. one's above and beyond.
Yeah, this one is, I mean, it is.
We all oohed and awed. It was like you brought your baby into the office.
I believe they call it extra.
Yeah, they the kids, with the kids, it's quite extra. Yes, yes, rather.
Rather extra.
It's rather what'd extra. I say?
My Joe. Would you look at that console?
We need to get him on the show.
Yeah, I know.
Glenn PV or whatever.
He's just
going to
sit over there and just give us.
Yeah, yeah. He could like shout.
Moving along, boys.
Yeah, God knows. we could use that sort of editing.
Ever since Laura left, we've been a mess.
No, it's yes, that's true. All right, last thing I wanted to mention was our good friends at Ubisoft. And they are good people.
They are good people.
They've decided we're just going to slash prices left, right, and center for Xbox One. And so there's a big Ubisoft sale happening right now on Xbox One.
There is.
So stuff, all these Assassin's games, Far Cry games. You can get Far Cry 5 for, what is that, like 40% off, 45% off? For Honor, Rainbow Six Siege, which everyone's playing. South Park,
are they,
Steep,
Jeffrey?
The
are they playing it?
Rainbow Six Siege is incredibly popular. They did a really good job on the esports
really
side and really all listening to their fans on that game. Trials of the Blood Dragon, that was a fun one. Watch Dogs 2, which I love, that one is well over 50% off. It's like 70% off. Wow, they actually had the numbers up there, and I'm sitting here trying to do math.
Yep.
Steep, you know, I miss my snowboarding. Could play some Steep.
Oh, man, those are the days.
I'm already planning.
Those were the days.
What do you mean, those were the days? I'm going back this winter. Those were the days. Yeah.
Okay. What's the dear podcast listeners and viewers and followers of Jeff and I on Twitter? Let us know what your over under is on what he's going to hurt this year. You're going to break a leg, an arm.
I don't know. And ribs usually tend to be the case. Maybe a knee.
A knee.
I hope not.
Take an arrow to the knee. Every callback to Aaron. Haven't heard that one in a while.
And I was okay with that, to be honest. Yeah, my goal is injury avoidance.
Yeah,
but it's still fun. You know. Occasionally, I feel like out of like an 8-hour day of skiing, there's 3 or 4 minutes where I looked cool.
Yeah,
and if someone was following me
with
and could edit that together,
flowing through your hair,
I wear a helmet. Are you crazy, Larry? I would
and
just
your
kill myself.
Goggles, yeah. Looking all svelte, coming down that hill in your spandex suit, picking up speed as
Cortex.
Cortex, Larry. As you hit that mogul.
Yeah, Larry. You sound like someone who's been around people talking about skiing before.
I never went skiing.
I can tell.
I went water skiing.
You don't
want to. I'm a great water skier.
You'd kill yourself. Really? I may have seen pictures as to this. I've never
been
water skiing.
I would be up at Cypress Gardens.
Give me some good water skiing. Very good. Give me some good water skiing terminology. What do people not know?
They're all the same.
Is
as
like
skiing.
A triple frumpy or something. No, is that like
sure
a cool
triple
move?
Frumpy? That's
yeah,
me.
Yeah.
That's me.
I mean, maybe.
I used to go mono ski. I could do mono ski back in the day.
Like
one ski.
Really?
Yeah.
Isn't that how they typically do it?
No, you have two skis, and you have one ski with one behind the
other. That seems safer.
It doesn't matter.
I don't really know. I stay out of the water. If I can't stand
in it. You have this massive allergy to the water.
It's called a phobia, and it's because I don't want to drown.
But that's why you learn how to swim. That's why I go scuba diving, and I love water. I've always
like
been
around. Work.
I will tell you this, though. This is probably something this is true. Okay? This is not rehearsed. This is something you don't know about me. Okay?
I'm ready.
When I was a little boy, when I was swimming, I was ready to do a backflip off of the diving board.
Yeah,
and I went back on my toes, and the water was real, and I slipped. The diving board came up, cracked me here. Can you see that little hanger under there?
Can still see. I thought that was from a shaving accident.
No, that is actually you can see the slice across the bottom of my chin.
God,
it was when I went down, cracked like this, knocked myself out.
Really?
Went into the water, and now I'm because you're in the diving
board. Rescued, right?
You're in the deep end.
Yeah.
And I was like, I just remember floating to the bottom. They came in after me. I came to the top.
Oh,
oh
wow.
It was bad. It was
you're lucky. I mean, if that diving board had hit a little higher,
yeah,
we wouldn't know you.
No, that's right.
It would have taken out the moneymaker.
Or something.
Yeah.
Is that what you call my nose?
Well, I mean, if it hit you, it's like, not the face.
Not the face.
It
was brutal. Could have
been bad.
It's brutal.
Wow.
Anyway.
And you're going to talk about what I'm going to hurt myself while you're falling off diving boards.
I was like 7 years old.
I don't know.
So
look, that's
apparently they don't allow diving boards anymore.
What?
Yeah, people hurt themselves. We're in this
legit. Where do they not allow diving boards?
In pools. Where else
would they have one? I can understand not having a diving board, you know, like city street or
this
something.
Is what
but
I was told.
Where are you getting your information
they don't,
from?
They don't have them at public pools.
I don't have any evidence to the contrary, okay. But I'm going to keep my eye out.
Okay.
And every time I see a diving board at a public pool, you'll know about it.
Please do.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I just can't believe this.
I'm giving you the facts.
Is it because of you? Because
no,
you
a
fell?
Friend of mine was building a pool, and they said they can't have it. They can't have it, and because of two things, they don't put them in public pools anymore because it's too expensive for insurance, and
sure.
B, you have to have much deeper water now.
Well, that's probably.
But that wouldn't have helped me if when I had slipped, I would have just gone deeper.
Yeah. I guess that's true.
Anyway, all right, enough about this.
Yeah. I wanted to say something about Hurricane Florence and just.
Hurricane Florence.
Well.
I don't know when we're going to post this show, but I'm sure it's going to be just about making landfall. So be careful down there because I've been in my I know you've been in your share.
Yeah,
of hurricanes.
Yeah. Hurricane Andrew.
You used to have
Aaron.
To be the weatherman telling people
well,
to get
that
out
too,
of town, right?
It was actually genuinely frightening that people would listen to my advice on how to protect themselves. But what I would say is don't do anything stupid.
Right.
Like stay away from your windows.
Right.
You can be very curious. What was that noise? Did this tree fall over? Whatever it might be. Stay away from the windows. It's not worth it.
Yeah.
And especially afterwards, that's where the problems are.
Sure.
A lot of times it's like, you know, wires can be down.
They
just
could be
energized. Just let people come to you and fix things.
Yes.
You know, so we're thinking about you there, but
were you living in Miami when the zoo animals were?
Yeah, that was Hurricane Andrew, 1992.
Terrible.
August. I was there and, it was a heck of a night. Fortunately, for my neighborhood, and very unfortunately for areas like Cutler Ridge and Kendall, in Homestead, it jogged south. So my area, which was slightly further north, was mostly spared, but you know, it's scary stuff.
Yeah.
And,
so
be careful.
So in North Carolina and everybody in the path of the hurricane, any hurricane, just be careful and heed the authorities and don't be stupid.
Yeah. Right? Don't be overly curious and trained professionals, whatever
you're doing, it's not worth the Instagram selfie.
That's basically the thing.
That's really what it's all about.
Yeah. Let the weather people do that. You see all these montages of weather.
Have you
people
done?
That
you've
are
done
there.
That.
Standing out in the rain? Yeah. Heck no! I would never got paid.
You were
enough
in
for
the
that.
Studio in front of the green screen.
Yeah, exactly. This is what you need to know. Now I'm not gonna. What is the point of that? You're standing out. Hey, it's windy. We get it.
Yeah.
Okay. Don't stand outside and get hit by a blowing, you know, lounge chair.
A trash can.
And look, a lounge chair,
an umbrella,
an Adirondack chair going at 75 miles an hour.
That is a weapon.
That is a projectile.
That is
you
a weapon.
You don't want to be anywhere near that. Anyway.
All right.
That's what I'll be thinking about this weekend.
You know what we're going to do? We're gonna wrap up the show.
We should do that.
We gotta get people going here. We wanted to come in the studio. I know we only gave you about half hour, 45 minutes of show, but we wanted to get in.
It's more than most people want.
It's way more. We're going to try to get into the Mixer studio in the near future. We got another episode of Inside Xbox coming up. Jeff and I will be live. He'll be in the UK. I'll be here. That's coming up at the end of the month. Right?
It sure is.
It sure. You're leaving soon, actually, right?
Yeah, I'm going to go and take in an Arsenal match. That's a soccer thing.
I know, it's football.
Correct.
Okay.
Can't wait. I love London. It's my favorite place to be.
A jolly good time,
yeah,
Jeffrey.
I'm going to look down. I'm going to look for the narrator from Strange Brigade.
So, anyway. All right, well, if you want to follow Jeff and you want to complain, make sure you hit him up on Twitter. You can follow him
at Jeff Rubenstein.
Hit me up at Major Nelson. And, hey, gang, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.